Hey guys, Cobra here. Well, as you would have seen in that in-store footage, I managed to find this new 2019 Nightburnerz 5-pack at Kmart today on the way home from work. Very lucky, I just thought I might pop in and just see what they've got, and they'd had that restock as you saw in the video. So I'm just going to do a quick unboxing of this because there's definitely some cars in here that I want to add to my loose collection. Of course, there was only one of these on the pegs. I normally do open my 5-packs and put them in my loose collection, so that's not really much of an issue. Really nice packaging though. I'll just show the packaging before I cut it open. A little hard with this angle to put this up vertically, but you can see all the casting names there and that cool card artwork at the top. So this is quite an unusual 5-pack in that it has three JDMs and Ford and a Chevy, but you've got those three JDM models, a Nissan, a Mazda, and a Fantasy Mad Manga, depending on how you pronounce that. So to open 5-packs, I generally just cut down the edge here, so kids, if you're watching, just make sure that you have some help or supervision from a parent or guardian. So as you can see, I'm just gently cutting down here, trying to cut it as straight as possible because I do tend to keep the 5-pack boxes once I'm done. So as you can see, I can just slide this out now. So I'm just going to put this up on top. I'm not sure how this video angle works. It's a little bit of a new angle for me, and it's night time, of course. It's winter down here in New Zealand, so it's quite dark, and I've just got the lights on in the room. So we'll start off with this 70 Chevelle SS. So what an awesome color on it. It's a beautiful metallic copper. And the graphics look fantastic. Sort of vintage, sort of 70s, 80s sort of style graphics on there. And those five spokes look pretty good on it. And they used a chrome interior, which means that they could do the chrome bumpers. Try and get you a look inside there. But you can just see how beautifully reflective that metallic copper paint is. I'm probably thinking this might be my favorite release of this casting, actually. I know there was one with Real Riders that was released in one of the premium series, but I actually really like the graphics on this. So that's a real winner. So that's the 70 Chevelle SS. Now I'm just going to have to put these aside. I think I might just have to move the camera back while we're filming, I'm sorry. Which is a little bit unusual, but here we go. 70 Chevelle. Next up, the Mad Manga. Now I have actually, or Manga, depending how you pronounce, I've been collecting this casting, so I have all of the releases of this, I think. And there you go. So it's just in a plain red. Usually the Mad Manga has some graphics on the top, on the roof or on the hood there. Normally has like a star logo or something like that, similar to what you see on the side. And look at that massive chin spoiler there, that shark mouth they call it. Fantastic. It's running on those tiny little open hole five spokes with yellow spokes and rim edges, and you've got those enormous exhaust pipes really over the top. So that looks really cool, and I'll just show you the base so you can see the way that these body parts here, these extra body panels fit around the base, the side skirts and the spoilers. And while we're at it, I may as well show you the base on the Chevelle as well. Not sure what this little notch here is. There's a little rectangular notch in the base there. If anyone knows, let us know through a comment on the video. We're working our way up to my favorite, of course. So here we go, here's a Ford Escort. I have a few of these. I'm not a I don't have to collect all of this particular casting. It is a really nice casting, sort of a 80s, 90s style model. So I would have grown up with seeing these on the streets.
not obviously not done up like this unless I was going to a rally event, but really beautiful graphics in green. So the 10-spoke green wheels matching the graphics. And the base on that is grey. And it looks like this 5-pack is made in Indonesia, because you've got that made in Indonesia stamped on the bottom of the base there. Now this is a really unusual one. Kind of, again, a retro graphic style on it. And those gold aero disc sort of style wheels. Bit of a throwback. Really nice blue on that. It's kind of a dark blue with a little bit of metal flake in it. And a blue windscreen, blue tinted windscreen to match. But that sort of striping and the numbering on the side, which again looks a bit like rally decals, rally numbers, looks really cool. And that massive whale tail style spoiler on there, really high up. The interior, you can see the roll bars. You've got some center console details and the steering wheel, of course, on the right hand side, as it would be for a Japan released vehicle. Neat. And the base on that is actually chrome. And that is definitely made in Indonesia as well. So sometimes the 5-packs from Matchbox, I think, are made in Thailand. But it seems that the Hot Wheels 5-packs are now made in Indonesia. Shout out to all the Indonesian factory workers making our Hot Wheels. Thank you very much. Now this is my favourite in the pack, of course. This is the Hakosuka, or the Nissan Skyline 2000 GTX. And we haven't seen this in the mainline for a while, actually. I can't recall when we last saw this. But it's normally in the premium lines these days. Really loving the gold colour on that. It's got some metal flake in it as well. They've sort of gone, harked back to some sort of retro style graphics on these. And for me, I really love these. Beautiful job. So you've got some MC5 wheels on this by the look of things. Muscle car 5-spoke wheels. See if we can see inside. So you can just see the grey seats. And they're quite low backs. Well, actually, there's only one seat in there as I'm looking at it now. There's only one seat. There's only a driver's seat on the right-hand side, and it's a bucket seat, like an actual race car seat. But there is no roll cage in there. Previous releases of this have had roll cages. So, guys, I suggest looking out for a roll cage, non-roll cage variation, perhaps. I can't confirm if there is one, but that would be worth looking out for if you collect this particular model. And the base on that is black. And again, you can see it says made in Indonesia, and you've got quite a lot of detailing on there, including some exhausts that are ported out the side there, onto the passenger side, as it were. So this is a fabulous 5-pack for 2019. It's right up there, I'd say, with the Fast and Furious 5-pack as my favourite for 2019. A lot of castings there that we just haven't seen for a while, so really good to see them. So I hope you enjoyed the in-store footage plus this opening, and we'll see you in the next video.